In this video, we're going to begin the points in the coordinate plane CUDA software free worksheet, and you can find this within the geometry section. Our directions for numbers 1 and 2 are to plot each point. Really quickly, I want to review how to plot a point on a coordinate system. Here we have the x-axis. So think of this like a number line. Here is 0 on the x-axis, so positive numbers will be to the right, negative numbers will be going to the left. And here is the y-axis. Again, think of this like a number line. Here is 0 on the y-axis, so positive numbers are going to be going up, and negative numbers are going to be going down. So just remember that x is in the horizontal direction, and y is in the vertical direction. Now let's get started. For point J, we're going positive 5, and then positive 10, 5 in the x, and 10 in the y, since the x-coordinate is listed first. So starting at 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and now we need to go up 10. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So here is point J. Now let's do point I. 1, comma 9. So that's positive 1 in the x direction and then positive 9 in the y direction. So we're going 1 to the right and then 9 up. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. And here is where we'll place point I. Next, point H. We're going 6 in the x direction and then we're going down 9 in the y direction since it's negative. So going to the right 6 and then going down 9. So point H will be at point 6, negative 9. Next, point G, and G is negative in the x direction, so we're going negative 6, so to the left 6 and then up 8, since 8 is positive. So 6 to the left, and then 8 up. Now let's mark and label our point. Now for F, we're going 9 to the right, since 9 is our x-coordinate and 9 is positive, and we're going 0 up or down, so 0 in the y direction. So 9 to the right will put us between 8 and 10, and we're going 0 up or down, so we're going to stay on this x-axis. Next, point E is also going to intersect that x-axis since we're not moving any vertically. However, we're moving 6 to the left. So E falls at negative 6, 0. Next, we'll do D. We're going 8 to the left, and we're going 4 down. So here is 8 to the left, and then 4 down is 8, negative 4. So now let's label point D. Here we will have a third point that intersects the x-axis because, again, we're moving 0 in the y direction. So we're just going to go 5 to the right in the x. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So point C will be at 5, 0. B, we're moving 1 to the left and 1 down. So 1 to the left, mark that, move 1 down, and that is where our point will be. And finally, A. Both x and y are negative, so we know that we're moving to the left, 8, and down 1. So 8 to the left, and down 1. Point A. And those are all the points plotted in number 1. Let's look at number 2. A is 7, 10, so we're going 7 to the right, so 7 falls between 6 and 8. However, then we're going 10 up and 10 is our farthest line. So A falls here. For B, we're actually intersecting the y-axis since we're not moving to the left or to the right since our x-coordinate is 0, but we're still moving up 4, so here is B. For C, we're moving to the left 1, and we're moving up 10. So negative 1 in the x direction brings us here, but then we're going up 10 to here. D is negative 6, negative 6. So we're going to the left 6, which brings us here, and then we're going down 6, which brings us here. So point D is at negative 6, negative 6. For point E, x is a positive 10, so we're moving 10 units to the right. And since y is 0, we're not moving vertically, so E will remain on the x-axis. For F, we're moving positive in both directions. Our first number is our x-coordinate, so we're going to the right 9. Our second number is our y-coordinate, so then we're going up 7. So 9 to the right and up 7 is point F. For G, we're negative in both directions, so we're moving 3 to the left since we have negative 3 for our x-coordinate, and we're moving 4 down since we have negative 4 as our y-coordinate. Next, H, we have negative 4, negative 9, so moving to the left 4 and then moving down 9. Point H. Next is I, both are positive, so we're moving 4 to the right since 4 is our x-coordinate, and 1 up since 1 is our y-coordinate. And lastly, J, we're moving positive in the x-direction, that's 7 units to the right, and we're moving negative in the y-direction, so that's going to be 9 units down. So starting at 0, 0, we're going 7 to the right, and then 9 units down. Now let's look at number 3. For number 3, we're to state the coordinates of each point. And it looks like I will have points A through J, so let's start with point A. Point A, our x-coordinate, we're in the negative x direction, so our x-coordinate is negative 10, and our y-coordinate is a positive 2, since it's to the left and then up 2. So A is negative 10, 2. For B, here's our point B, and you can see that it's 10 up, and it's 6 over. So 6, 10, 6 to the right, 10 up is our coordinate for B. And C, here's point C. You can see that it's in the negative x direction, and we're going to go 8 units to the left, and then we're going to go down 3 units. So it's negative 8, negative 3. For point D, we're in the negative x and the negative y. And you can see that we're going negative 8 in the x as well as negative 8 in the y. So D is negative 8, negative 8. For point E, we're going over 1 in the x direction and down 5 in the y direction. So that's going to be a positive 1, negative 5. Point F, we're going positive 2 in the x and negative 4 in the y. Therefore, F is at 2, negative 4. Next, we'll do point G, which is here, and you can see that that's negative 7 in the x and positive 8 in the y. So that's going to be negative 7, positive 8 for the coordinates. Next, we'll have point H, which is positive 2, positive 5. So 2, 5. I, you can see we go over positive 8 in the x direction, and we go down 2 in the y direction. So that's going to be 8, negative 2. And lastly, we have point J. Looking in the x direction, you can see that we're going 7 to the left. And then when you're looking at the y direction, you can see that we went 5 down. Therefore, j is at negative 7, negative 5. I'll go ahead and stop this video here, and in the next video, we'll continue on to the second page and finish this worksheet. Please remember to like this video and subscribe to my channel. All likes and subscriptions are greatly appreciated.